an activity or a reading material, and then there is technology involved. That means they can see videos or different things on the laptop or tablet. Okay, it involves traditional method as well as technology. So traditional method of teaching, that is like a teacher explaining to one group and the other is using technology at the same time. One group interacts with the teacher and while other watching videos before or after the lesson. Maybe a group is watching a video before and the other group is with the teacher and she is explaining, or then after they finish, they will go back to the teaching thing and the other group will go back to the to watching videos. Now, advantages, and here the students are divided according to their level. There are higher order thinking students and there are lower order thinking students. So it is necessary first for us to divide them according to their level, because if we mix them up, then the higher order are going to go further and the lower order which are there in their group will be lacking behind. So it is necessary that we divide them into proper groups, and that a teacher can do through assessment that which students lag behind and which are the higher order thinking students, which they can go and watch the videos directly and get whatever learning material for themselves. Now, advantages of this is interaction between teacher and students builds good relationship between the teacher and student. So the students are they become free, because teacher gives them personal attention, so they become free to ask questions. They are always interacting with the teacher, and the parents get the message that teacher cares for the students. So even the parents know, they trust the teacher that she will guide our students well and they will be able to do their own discoveries and whatever they require.